In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Greetings, God's good people, and welcome. Today is Tuesday, the 22nd of June, 2021. You are listening to Catholic Meditation. I am Father Blessed. The Church celebrates the feast day of St. Paulinus of Nola, Bishop. It is also the feast day of St. John Fisher, Bishop, and Thomas More, Martyrs. Let us pray. Grant, O Lord, that we may always revere and love your holy name, for you never deprive of your guidance those you set firm on the foundation of your love. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever. Amen. The first reading is taken from the book of Genesis, chapter 13, verse 2 and verses 5 to 18. The responsorial psalm is taken from Psalm 15. The response to the psalm is, Lord, who may abide in your tent? The gospel is taken from St. Matthew, chapter 7, verse 6 and verses 12 to 14. I read from the gospel. At that time, Jesus said to his disciples, Do not give dogs what is holy, and do not throw your pearls before pigs, lest they trample them underfoot and turn to attack you. So whatever you wish that men would do to you, do so to them. For this is the law and the prophets. Enter by the narrow gate, for the gate is wide, and the way is easy that leads to destruction, and those who enter by it are many. For the gate is narrow, and the way is hard that leads to life, and those who find it are few. The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. The theme for today's meditation is always be grateful and appreciate others' goodness to you. Always be grateful and appreciate others' goodness to you. Beloved of God, today's gospel passage is a compilation of three very wise sayings of Jesus. First, he says, Do not give what is holy to dogs. Neither should you throw your pearls to pigs, or they will trample them underfoot and turn to tear you to pieces. What did Jesus mean by this? We won't be able to understand what he meant by what he said till we first understand why the mention of dogs and pigs. Why these two animals? These two animals were considered by Jews as outlawed or of very low value. To call someone a dog or a pig was to degrade them. Biblical and rabbinic sources associate dogs with violence and uncleanliness. In the book of Deuteronomy, chapter 23, verse 19, dogs are equated with prostitution. Even till this day, dogs are considered promiscuous and are used to describe promiscuous persons. The expression is said, "You are as promiscuous as a dog." Rabbi Moshe Iseles taught that dogs that were known to be very, very harmful should always be chained. In the Gospel of Matthew, chapter 15, verse 26, Jesus told the Canaanite woman that one cannot take the food meant for the children of the house and throw it to the house dogs. By this, he teased her because being a Canaanite, she was considered a pagan, an outcast, and not like the Jews, the pure blood. In the book of Leviticus, chapter 11, verses 7 to 8, the pig is mentioned as one of the unclean animals not to be eaten. Again, in the Gospel of Matthew, chapter 8, verses 28 to 34, and in the Gospel of Luke, chapter 8, verses 26 to 37, Jesus cast demons out of possessed men in the country of the Gadarenes and sent them into a herd of pigs. For these reasons, dogs and pigs were considered low class, and anyone called a dog or pig was meant in a very derogatory way to show how low class they were. Till this day, Muslims don't eat pork. In Jewish culture, to be called a dog or pig was a great insult and humiliation. So when Jesus said, "Do not give what is holy to dogs, neither should you throw your pearls to pigs, or they will trample them underfoot and turn and tear you to pieces," what he meant was, do not give things of value to people who will not value or appreciate them. Have you heard of the expression, "It is like a gold ring on a pig's nose"? Yes, because it will not value the gold ring and will still use that nose with the gold ring on it to dig mud. So why place a gold ring on a pig's nose for which it will have no value? There are truly, dear friends, some people we feel we waste our time advising or helping them. They never appreciate or value it. In fact, our advice or our help seems to have been wasted. Jesus was making reference this time to the Jews. Despite all he did for them, they did not value it. It was like a gold ring on a pig's nose. It seemed a waste. They were like dogs and pigs, and indeed, not only did they not value or appreciate, they devoured and tore him to pieces when they crucified him. It is true, we have to convince others of the truth. This is what the Bible says. Confer Matthew chapter 28, verse 19, 1 Peter chapter 3, verse 15, and Acts of the Apostles chapter 17, verse 2. But dear friends, you would also agree that speaking the truth to someone, there are two kinds of people. There are those who are willing to listen and to learn. Such people can easily be convinced or can see your point. There are also others who are hard-hearted. You cannot convince a person against his opinion. Such people, no matter how hard you try, no matter how convincing your truth may be, they will never see it. They will never accept it or appreciate it. They are the kinds of people Jesus describes as giving what is holy to dogs and to pigs. They will not appreciate it. There are some people, no matter how much effort you spend on them, it seems a waste because they never value it or appreciate it or make good use of what you do. Today, therefore, ask yourself, do you appreciate and value the goodness of others in your life? Or could you also be described as a dog or a pig, lacking appreciation and a sense of value? No wonder, again it is said, you never know the worth of what you have till you would have lost it. Let us not be like the Jews whom Jesus described as dogs and pigs, not wanting to throw what is of value to them. What use do you make of the priests who preach to you? What use do you make of the sacraments that are given to you? What use do you make of the Bible, the church, and all these privileges that God has given you? Should it also be said to you, as it was said to the Jews, that you are a pig or a dog because what is holy has been given to you and you do not value and appreciate it? Again, ask yourself, if you were to die and go to hell, what excuse would you give God despite all these opportunities and privileges that you had? So you see, do not make of yourself a dog or a pig for whom nothing of value is appreciated. Secondly, Jesus gave the golden rule: do unto others what you would like done to you. This we find exactly in today's first reading. Abraham was with his nephew Lot, and after he had seen the land that was given to him by God, a dispute broke out, and Abraham told Lot, "No, I will not allow us to have problems because of land. You choose. If you go left, I would go right. And if you go right, I would go left." This is a practical example of the golden rule. He did exactly to Lot what he would have liked done to him. How often we always complain that we are not loved. Have you loved before asking to be loved? How often we complain that we are not respected. Have you first respected before asking to be respected in return? So you see, we always want to be at the receiving end but never ready to give out. We complain of those who do not give us what is our due, but we fail to realize how many times we have failed to give them what is their own due. Do unto others what you like done to you. If you know you do not want to be cheated, do not cheat. If you know you do not want to be disrespected, then do not disrespect others. If you know you want to be loved and appreciated, love and appreciate. Dear friends, the measure you give out is the measure that will come back to you. That is the golden rule. Do unto others what you like done to you. To conclude, Jesus makes the third statement: struggle to enter by the narrow gate. For the narrow gate is very hard to get through it. But the wider gate, many use it because it is easy. I remember as kids, while learning doctrine for First Communion and baptism, the catechist, I still picture him, told us that there were two roads that led to heaven. One, so smooth, so nice, tarred with street lights, and the other, rocky and stony with broken bottles. Then he asked us, which of the two roads do we really think could take us to heaven? Of course, your guess is as good as mine. We said it was the tarred road, the smooth road, because we imagined the beauty of heaven. Definitely, it would be the smooth road to take us there. But to our utter shock and dismay, the catechist told us, no, not the smooth road, the stony and rocky one. We were confused, but how could it be? And he explained, it is a metaphor. Dear friend, if you want it easy, if you want it smooth, you will never make heaven. Because what is the smooth way? It is to give it back to those who hurt you. It is to hate those who hate you. It is to slap the one who slaps you. But the hard way is the other way, to forgive those who hurt you. It is not easy, right? But that is the road that takes you to heaven. It is to give a smile even to that one who hates you. It is not easy, right? But those are the broken bottles on which you have to step to make heaven. So, dear friends, the life and death have been placed in your hands. You either choose the road that leads to perdition or the road that leads to glory. You either choose to pass through the narrow gate, which is the hard way, but the only way, or you choose to go through the wide gate, the smooth way, but which will lead you to perdition. Dear friends, choose wisely. The road to heaven is never easy. If it were, Jesus would not have carried the cross all through 14 stations to Calvary. After the rain comes the sun. No sweat, no sweat, no pain, no gain. until we pass through the narrow gate, then can we make heaven. O dear Lord, give us the grace, through the intercession of Saints Paulinus, John Fisher, and Thomas More, that we may persevere by using the narrow gate, and in doing unto others what we like done to them, so that we may value the beautiful things that have been given to us and appreciate the gospel that has been preached to us. Amen. Catholic meditation with me, Father Blessed. The Lord be with you. May the blessing of Almighty God, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit come on you and remain with you forever. Amen.